Hello everyone, welcome to the class. So in this class we'll be discussing questions related to ordering and sequencing. We'll also discuss how to approach such questions. Okay, let's begin. So before I actually start with my class, let me just tell you a bit about myself. My name is Aishwarya and I have done my master's in mathematics from University of Delhi, and prior to that I have done my graduation in mathematics from Miranda House University of Delhi. I have a total of 4 years of training experience for various management entrances like CAT, GRE and GMAT. Alright, so this was all about me. So now let me just explain you about the benefits of taking a plus subscription and an iconic subscription. Okay, so if you go for the plus subscription, then you will have opportunity to study from India's top educators. All the classes that happen on our platform are live and interactive classes. You can get your doubts clarified within the class itself. After each and every class, you will get the structured notes of each and every topic that was being taught in the class. Along with that, you will have access to the live tests and quizzes that happen on our platform on a daily basis. Alright, so these are the benefits of the plus subscription that you'll have. Along with this, we have one more kind of subscription, that is the iconic subscription, right? So all the benefits of the plus subscription will be there in the iconic subscription, but along with that you will get personalized attention from a educator, test analysis of each and every test that you attempt on our platform would be given to you. Preparation for other management entrances is also there. All right, so these are all the benefits of our subscription. Now these are the pricing for the CAT plus subscription. Okay, so the price for 12-month subscription is 17,500 and the price for 24-month subscription is 21,000. Okay, so over this fees, you can use my code AAISH10 to get the instant 10% off. Alright, so please use this code to avail 10% off the entire course fee. This is the price of our iconic subscription. For 12 months, it is 30,000 and for 24 months, it is 41,000. Here also you can use my code AAISH10 to get the instant 10% off the course fee. After the discount, the fees would be 27,000 for 12 months and 36,900 for the period of 24 months. Yes, hi Prasanna, welcome to the class. Good afternoon. Alright, so these are the students who have aced CAT 2020. These students have scored really well in CAT 2020. All of them have more than 99 percentile. So you guys can also be among these group of people this year if you ace CAT 2021. So for that, you have to go for the iconic or plus subscription of CAT on Unacademy. So please go for the subscription and start your preparations with us. This is the information about the batches that we have recently started. Okay, so you still have time to join these batches. Now this is a wonderful opportunity for you guys. We conduct this weekly scholarship test. Okay, you can access this test using my code AAISH10. Please use this code to unlock the test and start. And if you score well in this test, then definitely you will be getting a good scholarship. This is a wonderful feature on the app. There is an Ask a Doubt tab on the app. Click on the tab, then take a picture of the question that you want to ask. Okay, select the picture from your gallery, crop the picture so that the question becomes readable, and then you can submit it on our website. Okay, choose the subject from which the question belongs, and our educators will solve that question and share the explanation with you as soon as possible. Thank you. So these are all the benefits of the Unacademy platform. Now this is the name of our YouTube channel. You can join this YouTube channel, okay, to get regular updates about the classes. Also, this is my Telegram channel. I post about the links of my classes and everything there. We can also have discussion related to some doubts if you have any on this channel. Alright. Okay. Alright. Now, let us discuss some important guidelines of ordering and sequencing. Now, we have done one class on linear arrangement and circular arrangement. Okay. So ordering and sequencing is also quite related to that topic, but there is one difference. In the questions related to linear arrangement, there cannot be two objects or people sitting at one position. But in questions involving ordering or comparison, we can put two objects at a single position also. Okay, so this we'll be doing in the questions itself. So the questions will involve arranging objects in either ascending order or descending order. Okay, so we have to arrange. Now, what do I mean by this ascending and descending order? Some quantities would be given. So either the money with the people or their heights, their weights. Okay, so something, some parameter would be there on which we will be arranging the different objects or people. Okay, so let's see this in different questions also. So one important thing in ordering and sequencing questions is that two objects can be at the same position as well. Okay, also not greater than means less than or equal to. Okay, so if I say that A is not greater than B. Okay, so the negation of this sentence, the opposite of this sentence is not that A is less than B. Okay, it is A is less than or equal to. So you have to be careful about this equal to thing here. Similarly, not less than means greater than or equal to. So I hope these guidelines of solving the ordering and sequencing questions are clear. We'll be approaching the questions in the similar manner as linear arrangement. Okay, so let's start. What we'll do over here is that we will read the paragraph. Okay, we will read one sentence at a time. Then we will denote that we'll represent everything given in that sentence on a paper. Then we'll move on to the next statement. Okay, so note down everything as you read the question. Okay, let's start. So the question here says that A, B, C, D, E are 5 cars while P, Q, R are 3 motorcycles. Okay, let's continue. A is the fastest of the cars and R is the slowest of the motorcycles. Okay, so let us represent this statement. Let's see how will I do that. Okay, so what I'll do is that since it is given that A is fastest of the motorcycles, okay, so what I'm going to do is there are 5 cars, so I will make 5 positions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the 5 positions for cars. Okay, so here I'm going to write the fastest car and this is the position for the slowest car. Okay, now let's order them. So since A is the fastest car, this is the position for A and R is the slowest of the motorcycles. So there are 3 motorcycles, so these are the 3 positions. So okay, so this is for motorcycles. R is the slowest of them, so here I am going to place R. Okay, so the first statement is already labeled. Let's move on to the next statement. The next statement says that C is costlier than D. So from here I can represent it in this manner. Okay, so there are 2 parameters given here. One is the speed, other is the cost. So let us make 2 columns. First column is of speed, other column is of cost. Okay, so that I can represent everything in the correct column. Okay, so C is costlier than D, done. Then D and Q. Okay, it means C is costlier than Q also. Okay, but cheaper than B. It means I can write B is greater than C. Okay, so this is what I know till here. Okay, let's continue. Among cars, A is not the costliest. Okay, so if this is the arrangement, this is the ordering on the basis of their speed. Okay, so there is one more order that I have to make on the basis of their cost. So if I write the costliest car here and this is the cheapest one, this side. Okay, so there are 5 positions for the car. Okay, so please keep in mind that we are making 2 different arrangements here. Okay, let's see. So since A is not the costliest, this position is not for A. This is how I represent it. Let's continue. D is cheaper than E. Okay, hence again cost. The cost of E is greater than D. And there is no car which lies between these two. Okay, so there is no car between E and D. Hence E and D would be together in the arrangement. Okay, E is faster than 3 of the cars. Okay, hence E is faster than 3 of the cars means 1, 2, 3. The position of A is E is specified to be here. Okay, so this I have marked. Let's continue. Okay, E is faster than three of the cars and all the motorcycles. Hence, the motorcycles, the speed of all the motorcycles would be less than A as well as E. Okay, Q is costlier than R. Since Q is costlier than R, but Q and R are motorcycles. Okay, so let us make one more arrangement for the motorcycles. Here I know that Q is greater than R but cheaper than P. Okay, so this is the entire arrangement I have got for motorcycles. So this is P, Q, R, from costliest to the cheapest one. I hope this arrangement is clear. Now P is faster than Q. So here also I have P is faster than Q. Since it is given that P is faster than Q and R is the slowest of the motorcycles given from this statement, this is the arrangement for P, Q and R. Alright, so I have got the order of their speeds and the order of their cost. Okay, so I have got these many restrictions till now. Okay, so I hope this entire paragraph is clear to everyone. If this paragraph is clear to everyone, please give me a thumbs up. Okay, all right, so I have this order till here. Let's continue with the question. Let's see what the question is saying. Okay, so the question says, which of the following cars cannot stand exactly in the middle position among cars as far as their cost is concerned? Okay, so in this arrangement, which of the following cars cannot be at this position, the middle position? This is what the question is asking. Okay, now let's see what are the options. So the first option is A. But since A is not at the first position, but A could be here. Okay, so this is one of the possible answers. Now see, we haven't arranged these restrictions that we have got. We have got certain inequalities. Let us try to arrange these inequalities in the arrangement that we have. Okay, let's do that. So I have C is greater than D and C is greater than Q, and it is given that B is greater than C. Alright, so since A cannot be at this place, so I think B can be at this place. Okay, and I know that B is greater than C, so let us keep C at this position. Now I know that D and, yes, so D is after C, right? So I can place D here. Now still I have to put A and E at some place. Okay, but I know that E is greater than D. Means D has to come here and E would be at this position. Okay, so this is the arrangement that I have till now. Okay, now the position of A would be here. A could be at this place, right? Or A could be in middle of these cars as well. Okay, now let's come to the question. Let's see what the question is asking. So, can A take the middle position? Yes, it can. It cannot take the first position. It can take any other position than the first position. Now, let's come to option B. Option B is C. Okay. Can C take this position, the middle position? Yes, C can be at the middle position if I put any one car here. Okay, since I don't know whether E is less than C, it could be less than C. It means E can come at this position and then C would be in middle. So this is also one of the possible answers. Let's see for E. Yes, E could be in the middle position, as in this arrangement, it is in the middle position. Alright, now what about D? Now see, there are three cars which are greater than D. This we know for sure. Hence, D cannot be at the third position. It will either be at the fourth position or the last position, right? It means the correct answer to this question is option D. All right. I hope this question is clear to everyone. We are solving the question in the similar manner as we solve a linear arrangement question, but just we have to keep in mind, we just have to keep one very important point in mind, that at one position there could be two objects also. In this question, if you see, I can say that the speed of two cars is same, or the cost of two cars is same, right? So this is how we'll solve such questions. I hope this is clear to all. Let's move on to the next question of the same set. Okay, so before we read the question, let me just list down the arrangement that I have got till now. I have A, E, then three spaces available for cars, and I have P, Q, R. This is the arrangement for the speed. Okay, now let us list down the arrangement for the cost. So for the cost, we have got B, C, E, D. Okay, I have to place A somewhere, and this is also E can be at some other position also, but P, Q, R is fixed. This arrangement is fixed on the basis of cost. Let's see what the question is saying. So the question says, which of the following statements is true about the motorcycles? Okay, so we are concerned about P, Q and R here. Now let us read each option one by one and let's figure out whether it is true or false. Alright, let's see option A. It says that P is the costliest. Yes, it is the costliest, as well as the fastest. Yes, it is the fastest of the cars. Alright. Yes. So it means that this statement is true. Alright. Yes. Hello Deepak. Welcome to the class. Yes, you can watch the lecture for IP Mat also. Some of the concepts that I teach in this class would be useful there. Okay, let us continue with the question. Please try to solve this question and tell me what would be the answer. Alright, let's continue with the next statement. The next statement says that the fastest motorcycle is not the costliest motorcycle. But this statement is true. This statement is false, as the fastest motorcycle is the costliest one also here. Hence, this statement is false. Let's see the second one. The slowest motorcycle, that is R, is also the cheapest one. Yes. Hence, this statement is also true. Therefore, the correct answer to this question would be option D. Option D is the correct answer. Alright, I hope this question is clear to everyone. Okay, now let us continue with the same question of the next question of the same set. Okay, so now before I read the question, let me just list down the entire arrangement that we have got. So we have got A, E, three spaces, then PQR. This is the order in the case of speed, and the order in the case of cost is PQR. We have B, C, E, D. Okay, this is what we have got. Let's see the question now. So the question says, if P is costlier than E. Okay, so here it is given that P is costlier than E. How many cars are cheaper than P? Okay, let's see. Now see, it is given that P is costlier than E. Okay, so I don't know the position of A. So A could be at this position. So if A is at this position, means B, C, E, D, A. If this is the correct order, then if P is costlier than E, P would be here. Three cars would be cheaper than P. Okay. But if A is at some other position, like this is the position, okay, then number of cars that are cheaper than P would be 2. Okay, so since I am not aware about the position of A, this cannot be determined. Hence, the correct answer to this question would be option choice D. I hope this question is also clear to everyone. Let's move on to the next question. The arrangement is the same. Please read the question and try to answer it. Okay, let's begin. So the question is, which of these is the slowest of the cars? Slowest of the cars means the car which will be at this position. Okay, let's see. So if B and C are faster than D, okay, so it is given, I have a new restriction now, it is given that B is faster than D and C is also faster than D. Okay, it means that B and C would occupy these two positions. Hence, D would be at this position. There is no other possibility. Hence, D is the slowest of the cars. Option B is the correct answer here. Alright. So, we are done with this set. I hope all the questions for this set is clear. Now, here we have two different parameters for solving the question. We had to arrange the cars and motorcycles on the basis of their cost, as well as on the basis of their speed. Okay, so often in such type of questions you have to make two arrangements. The method of solving such questions would be same as linear arrangement. We just have to keep one thing, one point in our mind. The very important point is there at a particular position there can be two objects placed. Okay, so this is what we have to keep in mind while solving this question. Rest everything is like linear arrangement. Okay, so let us try to solve one more set. Okay, so here this is a set that I have. Let us try to solve it together. Okay, so the question says that this paragraph is J, K, L, M, and N are five boys in the class. They are ranked in the order of their heights from tallest to shortest. So this is one parameter. I have to arrange these five boys on the basis of their height and in order of their cleverness. What is cleverness? Okay. We have to arrange them in the order of their cleverness. So these are the two parameters that I have, height and cleverness. Okay, so I'll make two columns here. Okay, so that when I write all the inequalities, there is no confusion and everything would be clear. Okay, so this is cleverness. So these are the two arrangements. These are the two parameters. On these parameters, I have to arrange these five boys. Alright, let's see. From cleverest to dullest. Okay, K is taller than N. So this would be on this section. K is taller than N. This is how I represent it. But not as clever as J and L. Okay, hence J and L, both of them are more clever than K. This is what I have from this statement. Let's see. Whereas M is the cleverest of all. M is the cleverest means he is the most clever person. So, okay. So, this is the cleverest position. This is the position of the dullest person. So, I have 5. So, I am going to make 5 spaces. And M would be at the first space according to this statement. Alright. Let's continue. But shorter than J. Shorter than J means M, the height of M is shorter than J. This is what I have. So again, let me draw one more arrangement on the basis of their height. Tallest to shortest, 5 spaces are there that we need to fill. Okay, let's continue. So the next statement says that while L is shorter than M, okay, hence M is taller than L represented, but taller than, while L is shorter than M, but taller than K. Hence, it is given that L is taller than K. Okay. So have I got the entire arrangement here? Let us try to fill all the five boys in this row according to their heights. So I know that M is the cleverest one, okay? But I am filling for the heights, okay? So we will fill this arrangement first. It is given that K is greater than N, okay? But K is less than L and L is less than J and M. So hence, J is the tallest person. Then I have M, then L according to this that we have written. Okay, then L is taller than K and K is taller than N. Hence, this is the arrangement if I order all the boys on the basis of their heights. I hope this is clear. Now let us move on to the cleverness part, this part, okay? So for this, M is the cleverest of all, this I know. While L is shorter than M, okay, and taller than K, L is not as clever as J, okay? Hence, J is greater than L. From this statement, I can say that J is greater than L. Alright, now let's see. No two persons got the same ranks in any of these parameters. Now this is very important statement given here. No two persons got same ranks. Same ranks means at one particular position, we cannot place two persons there in this question. Okay, so this is what I need to remember. I have completed the arrangement on the basis of their height. For cleverness, I just know that M is the cleverest and let us try to put these also here. So J is greater than L and J and L both are greater than K. Okay, so if I put J and L here, K would be there. Okay, but still I have one position left for N. Okay, so let us read the statement. Let us read the question first and then see. So the question says that who is the third in order of the heights? So from here I can clearly see that L is at the third position. Hence L is the correct answer to this question. Option D is the correct answer. Alright, let's move on to the next question. So the order on the basis of their heights is J, M, L, K, N. This is the order on the basis of their heights. On the basis of cleverness, I know that M is the cleverest. Alright, this is what I know. And the restrictions are J and L are more clever than K. And J is greater than L. This is all I know. Now let's read the question first. The question says that if N is not the last in at least one of the two comparisons, okay? But in the first comparison, it is quite clear that N is the last person. Hence, in this comparison, N cannot come at the last position. So N has to be placed in any of these three positions, okay? But we know that J is greater than L and L is greater than K. Okay, so this is the arrangement I have got. J is greater than L is greater than K. This is all I know. Okay, it means N has to be at either this position or this position or this position. Okay, so we'll fill accordingly. Okay, the question is, which of the following is dullest of the five? Okay, so it means these three positions would be occupied by J or L or N, right? The only person left is K. Hence, K would be here as he is the dullest of all. Therefore, the correct answer to this question would be option A. Alright, I hope this question is clear to everyone. Yes, if this question is clear, please give me a thumbs up. Yes, I hope this question is clear and the arrangement is clear to everyone. Okay, all right. Now let us continue with the next question. We have specified this order. Okay, so on the basis of cleverness, we know that M is the cleverest, and then there are four positions to be filled, and on the basis of their heights, okay, heights, this is the arrangement that I have. J, M, L, K, N. This is the arrangement on the basis of their heights. On the basis of cleverness, I have two restrictions, that is J is greater than L is greater than K. This is what I have. Okay, now let us read the question. The question says that if J is the third in order of cleverness, okay, hence I will put J here. Therefore, L and K would be here automatically using this relationship, and N would be at this position, as this is the only position left for N. Okay, then the question is asking, who is the second cleverest? Second cleverest person is N. Therefore, the correct answer to this question would be option B. Alright, option B is the correct answer here. Okay, I hope this question is also clear to everyone. Alright, okay. Let's continue with the next question. The arrangement, let us list down the arrangement that we have. So, on the basis of heights, the boys are arranged in this order. J, M, L, K, N. Okay. And on the basis of their cleverness, we know that M is the cleverest, and we have four positions to be filled with the relationship J is greater than K is greater than L. Sorry. The relationship is J is greater than L is greater than K. This is what I have. Now let us continue. The question is, who among the following is cleverer as well as taller than K? Okay, so taller than K means either J, M or L. Hence, option A could be one of the possible answers. N is not the possible answer. L and N is also not possible. Okay, let's continue. This was on the basis of their heights. Let's see on the basis of their cleverness. Okay, so R, J and L and M cleverer than K? Yes, I know that since K is the dullest of J, L and M, hence option A is the correct answer. Therefore, the correct answer here is option A. Okay, so this is the usefulness of all these questions. If you can get the arrangement correctly, if you give more time in reading the paragraph and making the arrangement, then if the arrangement is correct, then all the questions that will follow, 4 or 5, all these questions would be correct only. Okay, so it is very important to read the given paragraph carefully and make the arrangement. Alright, I hope this question is clear to all. Yes, please say a yes or okay in the chat box so that I can proceed to the next question. Alright, let's continue then. Okay, so again, the set is same. The question is different. Okay, please take a minute, read the question and try to answer this question. So this is the arrangement that I have till now for heights and for cleverness. Okay, let's read the question together. So the question says that who among the following is cleverer as well as taller than K? Okay, this question we have already done. This is the question that we need to do. How many people are definitely shorter than K? Okay, let me just redraw the arrangement. So we have J, M, L, K and N. And for cleverness, M is the cleverest. Then four spaces are to be filled and we have J is greater than L is greater than K. Okay, so this is the arrangement that we have. Let's see. So the question is, how many people are definitely shorter than K? Okay, so one person is definitely shorter than K. We can see this here, which is N. That person is N. So only one person is definitely shorter than K. Hence, the correct answer to this question is option A. Alright. So, I hope all the questions, all the 10 questions that we have discussed in this class are clear to everyone. Both the sets are clear. So, again, I will repeat that all the questions that we do in ordering and sequencing questions are similar to that of linear arrangement. The only difference is that at one position, we can fill two objects or two people also. Okay. So, please read each statement of the question clearly and then try to mark it on your paper. Then you continue to the next statement. Okay. So now practice more questions related to this topic. And I'm sure if you practice more questions, then this topic would be absolutely cleared. Okay. So this is a very interesting topic. Ordering and arrangement is very interesting, but for that a lot of practice is needed. Okay. Even if you practice just 30-40 sets, then I'm pretty sure that you'll be able to solve the questions correctly. All right. So this was the last question of this class. Okay. So now let me just tell you the benefits of the plus subscription of Unacademy. Okay, so on Unacademy, all the classes are live and interactive. You will have access to these classes if you take their subscriptions. You will also have opportunities to participate in the live tests and quizzes that happen on our platform. Okay, notes of each and every lecture are given to you after the lecture is over. Okay, so these are all the benefits of the plus subscription. You can go for this subscription. Okay, and you can use my code AAISH10 to get the 10% off the entire course fee. Alright, okay. So now you guys might be thinking, how can you subscribe to Unacademy? So the steps for that are very simple. Just go to Google Play Store, type Unacademy there and install the Unacademy Learning App. As soon as you'll install the Unacademy Learning App, it will ask you to select your goal. So you have to select your goal as CAT and then you click on get subscription. Then you just have to select the subscription which you want to go for, either the plus or iconic according to your needs. Okay. And then apply my code AAISH10 there. Okay. To get access to the subscriptions. Also, if you want to access my special classes on the Unacademy platform, you can use this code to unlock the mock test quizzes and the special classes that happen on the platform. Now, this is the name of our YouTube channel. Kindly follow our YouTube channel. Subscribe to the YouTube channel to attend classes regularly there. This is the name of my Telegram group. Please join this group to get updates about my classes on the Unacademy platform as well.